Joining us on NHRA Today is the former Top Fuel and Funny Car champion, Del Worsham, to talk about the 2017 Mello Yello drag racing season. Lewis Bloom here in the Wally Parks Studio, special guest in-house. Just drove up the 57 freeway. Former Top Fuel and Funny Car champion, Del Worsham. Del, thanks for stopping by.
Thank you, glad to be here.
Well, Del, when did you realize last year that you were going to transition from the Coletta team to going back to race with your dad?
You know, it wasn't something that I was really planning or I really even had like a date set on it. As the season went on and some stuff transpired and some changes were being made, I just started thinking, you know, if I was ever going to race with my dad again, it was probably about time to do it. So when some changes got made at Coletta's, the season was over and I started looking at my dad and myself, and it just seemed like a good time. If I'm going to race with him, you better do it now.
So some of the good news that has happened recently is the fact that the Lucas family is backing you for 6 races. How did that come about? And you got to be happy about it.
Very, very excited about it. It was, you know, when you're looking at sponsors, and I started so late in this project, you know, I didn't know what was going to happen or how we're going to make it happen. I just knew I was willing to, this is what I wanted to do. So started calling around, and when Lucas folded up, you know, when he shut the doors on his team, he was just a call I made. You know, Morgan and I have been friends for a long time. I remember when he worked on Rupert's car before he ever drove a car. So Jason had been around a long time, called him up, kind of explained to him my situation and my plans and where I wanted to go with this. And he was excited about it. And after a very little bit of time, we had come to an agreement.
Now, what about assembling the crew, you know, getting the people to work on the race car? How hard is that? How easy is that?
Well, my dad had some guys already worked on the team that will be coming along, and I'm excited to keep them along. You know, guys like Corey Lee, who have a lot of experience. He's been with my dad. He's driven our cars for us, so I'm really excited to have him on board. Then I've kind of gone back in the archives of some guys I used to have work for me. I've called on some old favors. Through my 27 years, I've met a lot of people. I know a lot of experienced people, so we're going to have a crew. We're putting it together right now, and it'll be experienced.
I know you could definitely have a low 390 tune-up. You're going to need a low 380 tune-up. Do you think you guys have that?
Well, I was part of a 380 tune-up, you know, so I've seen what it takes to do it. I know what's involved. I know what it costs. I know the parts and pieces. Getting it all together into mesh isn't all that easy. You know, I really don't know what this car will run. You know, we've never really ever really pushed it that hard or tried that hard with it. You know, Jim did a great job in it. He made some great runs in it for the little bit of running he did in it. So, I mean, I believe at some point it will. Whether or not it's going to come out of the Winter Nationals and run 385, who's to say? But I believe before this is all said and done, it'll be competitive and it'll run the numbers it needs to win.
You know, when you think about being with your dad on a full-time basis again, what's that going to be like?
My dad's very competitive, you know, and when we race together, I never know, you know, I know what he's like. You know, we'll get out there and also he'll start pushing and I'll start pushing and we'll take ourselves to new levels. So our last few years racing and competing probably didn't really show what's coming with us. You know, together as a team, we push each other, we run hard, and I'm sure we're gonna do everything we can do to win races.
Del, there's been some changes to the point system, points and a half at Indy, along with the final race of the season at the finals. You've won a championship. You know what it's like to count points at the end of the year. What's your thoughts on that?
It's going to be exciting. You know, there's ways to earn extra points now or to make things happen. And when you're strategizing, you're close to either making the cut or not making the cut or trying to win this championship, you're going to pay attention. So I think there's going to be a lot of excitement. Looking forward to it. And I hope in the first part of the season, I'm not having to worry about those points. And I hope in the back half of the season, I'm having to worry about them.
Absolutely. One last question. What is it going to be like when you line up against the DHL Toyota and JR Todd driving that race car? What are the emotions going to be like?
Oh, shoot, man. You know, there's no animosity here. You know, I left this team on my own will. You know, they gave me the option of what I wanted to do. So it's going to be exciting. JR worked for me years ago, you know, with our blue Checker Trucks Craig and car. So he's a great guy. I already watched him drive my car. So to race him in my old car should be fun. I mean, it's a great team over there. They're a lot of good friends. And it reminds me of maybe racing like a Ron Capps or Robert Height. You know, they're friends of mine, and I enjoy racing them.
Three people have won championships in both Top Fuel and Funny Car: Kenny Bernstein, Gary Selzy, and this guy. We need you on the racetrack, Del. Thanks for coming into the studio. Good luck this year. You're looking forward to the Winter Nationals like never before because you're racing again with your dad?
I wouldn't say like never before, but I'm looking forward to it like I have in the past. You know, it reminds me of 1990. It reminds me of 1997, and it also reminds me of 1991 when things were just new and fresh and getting going.
Del Worsham joins us in the studio. Thanks for stopping by. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Don't forget, for more content, keep it right here at NHRA.com. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and of course, Facebook.